fact, to my mind, there are two basic political tendencies today, not only in Greece, but all over Europe, and I would say and beyond, in the rest of the world. The first tendency is what we may call the globalist tendency. This is the tendency that does not question in any way globalization, does not question in any way the institutions of globalization, like the European Union, but just aims to improve the existing institutions. That's why, for example, both Syriza and Podemos in Spain and Die Linke in Germany, who belong to this tendency, simply criticize the austerity policies imposed by the European Union. They never raise any question of exiting from the European Union or for creating a different kind of union of the peoples in Europe and so on. This is absolutely wrong for my mind, both on political and economic reasons, but we can discuss it in a moment. And the other tendency is the anti-globalization tendency, which in fact is a development of the historical anti-globalization movement that developed in the early 2000s or in the late 1990s, but was crushed by the violence of the state as well as by the systematic effort that the globalist left that developed at the time to emasculate this movement. So today there is no anti-globalization movement in the sense of an anti-systemic movement. It is just some people who criticize globalization, not only in terms of changing the whole system of globalized economy or what I would call the new world order of neoliberal globalization. Because you can easily show that globalization in a capitalist market economy can only be neoliberal, cannot be anything else. So just to criticize Merkel or whoever that they are neoliberal, it's ridiculous, because they are neoliberal as long as they have opened and liberalized their markets. That's the essence of globalization.